The Fishing Pole, written and read by Alexander Kusztyk. An engine rumbles to life in the distance. I shut the car door and step onto the moist ground. The air is dry and a light breeze rustles the needles of the pine trees. There isn't even a cloud in the sky. This is the perfect day to go fishing with the family. I look down at the dock. The boats gently bob up and down in rhythm with the water. This whole place seems to calm my soul as I close my eyes and breathe in the fresh air. A bait shop sits right next to the dock ramp. With its door propped open, the shop seems to beckon us in. My dad tells me to grab my fishing pole so we can start our adventure. I reach into the trunk of the car and retrieve the rod. Its sleek form glistens in the sunlight. I hold it firmly and smile to myself. This pole has helped me catch so many fish. It almost feels like part of the family. In conjunction, we can reach a blissful state. I begin the descent to the bait shop. Another boat engine starts and the smell of gasoline wafts into my nose. I enter the shop with my parents. My dad walks up to the counter to purchase worms while I look around. Spinning reels and lures line the walls. I gaze up at the various nets and wonder if there are actually fish that big in the lake. My mom taps me on the shoulder and hands me a life jacket. We exit the shop and step onto the dock. The boards creak as I walk the length of the landing to our motorboat. I snap the life jacket securely over my shirt and, still clutching my fishing pole, step into the boat. The boat trembles as my dad starts the engine. I cannot help but smile. This is what heaven will be like. My dad skillfully maneuvers the boat out of the dock and hands me the controls. I gun the engine and excitedly steer the boat towards the center of the lake. My mom pulls out the camera and captures my beaming face, full of joy and laughter. We come to a stop and my dad heaves the anchor into the water. I watch as it splashes and begins to sink into the depths. The time has come to relax on the water. Like a medieval knight wielding his sword, I make my first cast into the lake. I sit and wait. This can be the hardest part about fishing, but I have learned to embrace it. An opportunity to be at peace in a fast-paced world such as this is truly a rarity. I patiently watch my bobber float in the water. After a good 30 minutes, I decide nothing is on this side of the boat. I glance over at my parents. My mom, propped up on the cushions, is reading a book, and my dad is silently watching his own bobber. If I'm going to have any luck today, I must try the other side. I lift the line out of the water and shift over to the other side. Out of the corner of my eye, I see my dad staring at me. Empowered, I hoist my rod over my head. With all my strength, I make my cast. My jaw drops as I watch my fishing pole sail out of my hand and into the lake. Immediately, my dad grabs for an oar and stretches out to try and coax the now sinking rod back to safety. All I can do is watch as my heart sinks with the rod. I watch as my friend drowns. In its last effort for life, the bobber strains to float, but the weight of the rod brings it down too. I peer into the murky depths and get a final glimpse of my rod as it catches the last rays of sunlight. I raise my hand to say farewell as my fishing pole slowly disappears from my life. 10 years from that day, my first fishing pole still remains at the bottom of Lake Mary. It is hard to witness the demise of something you love. The loss of my fishing pole helped me to fathom how things of this world perish. Even I will perish. From that day forth, I made it my aim to live each day as if it were my last. Mourning over personal loss will do no good in the grand scheme of things. Learning to move on from the past is a critical step one must take in order to be at peace. Continuing on after a loss may be challenging, but is profoundly important. The following year, my parents gave me a new dry fly fishing pole. I have become an avid fisherman and even tie my own flies now. Dry fly fishing is not a sport, but a lifestyle. Patiently sitting at water's edge relaxes the mind and body and helps one to realize the simple beauty of nature. Watching the water for many years has yielded a secret: to live life like a river, always flowing until it is no more.